My scientific research focuses on mirror neurons as a purely biological mechanism in the brain for empathy in rodents.
I'm studying metabolic dysfunction in Alzheimer's disease, looking in the hippocampus and in the dorsolateral prefrontal cortex, the different two parts of the brain that are implicated in Alzheimer's.
My research focus is on the adolescent onset of certain psychiatric disorders, such as anxiety disorders, major depressive disorders, and schizophrenia. Specifically, I focus on the inhibitory circuitry that might play a role in these disorders. The technique I use on a daily basis is electrophysiology. I usually perform whole cell patch clamp recordings on cells and measure the electrical input and output that are coming into the cell that I'm interested in recording.
I'm really big into protein assays, so protein quantification, because our substrate that we use is from postmortem brain. I've been doing a lot of PCR, Western blots, capillary electrophoresis, and enzyme activity assays.
Immunohistochemistry, optogenetic manipulation, and some behavioral tests like fear conditioning, elevated plus maze, open field are some techniques that I use in my project. I spend 8 hours per day in a lab and probably 6-7 hours on the bench.
When I'm in lab and actually doing work, I spend probably the majority of my day on the bench. And when it gets really busy, I can be in lab for quite a bit of time, up to 10 hours, but some days I can have just a little half day and I can be in and out in 5 or 4.
The amount of time I spend on the bench is pretty much just the preparation time it takes for the electrophysiology experiment. So I usually take about 2 to 3 hours a day, each day, when I am doing these electrophysiology experiments.
It's a really hard skill to learn, and it's been an interesting time and the transition from medical school to graduate school. Keeping people to hold you accountable for the things that you like to do, whether it's cooking or working out, and just having a really good support system. I found that to be very helpful in keeping my balance intact.
So what I like to do is I like to write down all of the things that I have to do, and then writing down all of my thoughts that go along with it in order to kind of organize myself. On top of that, I try to spend some time daily by just taking care of myself. I myself love to do yoga, so by practicing the deep breathing and kind of doing exercise helps me to balance this professional and personal life.
I make daily schedule, set priorities, and try not to overload it. And in this way, I am sure that I would have enough time to take care of my life afterward. Library, since it feels like everyone around you is looking for something new in science.
So the place I like to go to in order to wind down is the Mulford Library Annex. I like the fact that it's really quiet and that I'm able to sit and focus and either work on what I need to work on at a leisurely way, or if I could just sit and watch some TV.
I don't know if you can consider this campus, but there's a coffee shop on main campus that I really love to go to, whether to study or just to see my friends. And there's also a little courtyard on the health science campus that I love to sit at. A lot of good memories with my friends there.
COVID-19 pandemic is overwhelming, and everything has been surrounded by uncertainty in my academic life. There are some in-person training, which is needed in my project, and they've been canceled due to the pandemic, and I don't know if it's possible to take them online.
So I've had to shift a lot of my work to more computational biology and bioinformatics, and just doing a lot of writing and trying to really get my research interests focused.
COVID-19 had affected my research life in kind of setting a lot of the second year students as well as myself back a few months in research. So instead of starting by the spring semester, we had to start in the summer when everything was starting to regulate and we were able to figure out a way to make sure we were putting in the right precautions.
Definitely yes, I recommend Toledo.
I think it's a really good fit for me, considering the more smaller, intimate environment. I felt extremely supported by really good professors that have helped me hone in my interests.
The best part of being in Toledo as a student is that Toledo is a place where you can really focus on your academics and what you need to get done in order to succeed professionally. Toledo is a rather peaceful and quiet area, so you're capable of really buckling down and either going to metro parks that we have here to take a nice breath of fresh air, as well as decompress, and then the peace in order to focus on your studies and get what you need to get done.
I have really grown to love the city and the community that the University of Toledo has become a part of and fosters in the medical and then also in the research community. I've been really challenged by professors here, especially in my PhD years, to really become the best scientist I could possibly be.
I'm very thankful that my path led me to the University of Toledo because I'm so thankful that the faculty and staff that I've encountered are very encouraging and even through this pandemic have been very understandable as well as with the same balance of pushing you to keep growing and pursuing what needs to be done in order to achieve a PhD.